Raise and Beautiful Little Minds. On this video, we are going to discuss the Autism Evaluation Scaling Form. This is a form that is given out to certainly to this, children in Scotland, if there's a, whether a small or big chance of autism. And, possibly England, I'm not 100% sure. So yeah, so that's what this video is about. So stay tuned. So let me talk about what my feelings towards this form are. I had to fill it out twice. Simple reason being that the first one they lost, so I had to fill it again. Yes. So I was expecting it to score the same, or almost the same. But I actually found it was very different scoring. The score was much lower the second time. I don't know if that's due to the NemeCheck protocol. I don't know if it's just him growing. I don't know really. I personally believe me that it is the NemeCheck protocol, which is seeing so much vast improvement as every month that goes on. As this form is very detailed, most of the answers can only truly be filled out by parents, because you will find it that there's nursery or kindergarten, if it's America, they will not be able to fill out everything, because they only see your child for a short period of time. So always bear that in mind. Okay, so what is my son's reality at the moment? So I got a letter back from the development consultant. They said that my score compared to what my son's nursery was very different. Obviously he's going to have to be seen again by development and consultant. So this prompted me to ask the nursery to have a meeting, because I want to make sure that we are in the same understanding. I understand that they felt that the form was some time ago and improvements have certainly been made. But it's something that I feel that's very important for me to express to the nursery how I feel my son is ultimately doing. My concerns of I don't know how well they actually rank my son. So that is my reality. I will keep you all updated on how that goes in the next couple of weeks or months. Right now I'm going to post some pictures that you will see on this form. Obviously I won't post them all because there's many pages. But I'll generally give you an idea of what you can expect. So here they are now. Now, then you've had a look, you will see they are quite in depth. This is just how I feel at the moment regarding this form. I believe, if I'm honest, that I don't believe my son has it. Now, and I know that might come off as being naive. I don't know. If you had asked me that a while back, then I would probably say maybe yes. But now, with such a vast improvement he has made, I'm opting for no. I will never be sure 100%. But that's just my... So I would always urge parents, regardless if it's a yes that you get or a no, go with what you believe in your heart. So if my son gets evaluated and they say yes, then it's for me, because I don't agree with it, that might change in the future. But right now, since I don't agree with it, I'm never going to introduce my child, oh, this is my child, this is what they have. No. And that's not going to make me think of them any different, because ultimately, that is a consultant saying, this is how I think your son may have or does have. Again, they are the consultant, they are not the parent yourself, and you always need to bear that in mind. I've been told many times in my life, not in my son's life, in my own life, that certain situations are like this, when in reality they were not. Sometimes they got better, sometimes they got worse, and some things never even appeared. So go with, I always believe, go with your gut feeling. Don't go with your heart. Your heart will take, oh, miss me, I have suffered from many panic attacks, I've suffered, as any parent who's watching this video has dealt with a whole lot of stress regarding this topic. So, yeah. So as I said, I will keep you updated on his progress. Okay, so next clip, I'm actually going to discuss preparations you make with your nursery or kindergarten before your child enters schooling. As I said, from minutes on the tape, my son will be having a meeting because of this difference in evaluation. But that meeting is not just, that is what I want to bring up in the meeting. Truly, the meeting is going to be about the steps of what they feel and what I agree upon on things that need to happen to get him ready for school. So yeah, so that meeting is going to be all about how that meeting went, and maybe give you some tips and ideas. I know that I have some ideas that I want to ask the school if they are possible at all. Like for example, could I meet his primary one teacher prior to him starting? So just basic information like that. So I hope you stay tuned to that episode. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next Wednesday. Bye.